I've come to the unfortunate conclusion that if I want to do things the way I want to do things, that I need to either get a crapload more levels and much better equipment, or I just need to admit that this really isn't going to work out for the long haul and make some adjustments. So I've decided to call an audible, and we're going to make some adjustments. So we're going to modify our rules. Now, like I said early on, I wasn't certain that these rules would work out, and then I kind of had some potential other ideas for how it might end up needing to go, but I don't know. It's all kind of hard to say. Oh, look at that. I brought some friends with me. All right, let me get out of here for a second, because I don't really need to play with those guys. I'm actually over here for a reason, and it does involve some sort of creature or another. You know what, you guys, you're cramping my style over here. That's what you're doing. Do you realize that? Do you even care? Do you care that you're cramping my style? Because I actually do. All right, there we go. Good. I don't really need to fight it right now. I mean, whatever. I mean, I guess we could, but whatever. You go away, because I'm going to need to do a couple things right here, and it actually involves a little bit of this. Not a lot of it, but a little bit of this. We are going to need to do a little of this. I don't know how well this is going to work out, because what I would kind of like to do is grab one thing, but I suspect we're going to grab a bunch of others. So let's do it the smart way then, right? Right. Good call. Good call. I'm glad you said that. I appreciate that. Oh, hi. Hi, little Dimorphodon. That would be a dead fish right there. That is not what I'm looking for, believe it or not. I'm not looking for a dead fish. All right, what do we have? Oh, hello. Oh, man. That's actually, I wouldn't mind that right now. Level 130, holy cow. Well, here, let's, this might not work out well. Alright, we're gonna take this here, beaver. Why not? That's a little injured, and this might not end up working very well. I guess we'll find out. We're gonna just kind of fly it back this general direction. We're gonna see what happens here. These guys are little punks. I haven't thought this through very well, in fact. I've actually not thought it through at all, if I'm going to be honest here. So, this might not work out very well. I kind of should have done something before we started on this, but it's kind of too late for that. I mean, we can still do it, of course, but it's just kind of late to do it before we do everything else. So, whatever! Whatever, we're just going to run with it. We will figure this one out, I think. Maybe. Potentially. Probably. Alright, we're going to go ahead and drop you over here, and I'm going to see what happens. Now, this guy's a little upset with me, or this girl, sorry, she's probably a little upset with me, because I just took her from all of her friends. And all of her friends were about to be eaten by a really high-level T-Rex, so I think she's going to get over it. You know what? We can make this modification right now. I could. We sort of can. All right, we can do this. I think I can do this before it gets out of here. I think we can do this. It'll work out. I need to do a little choppy-choppy here, so let's get rid of that guy, and then theoretically I can make me a wooden wall. I don't even know that this is actually really going to work. We're going to find out. Let me put you down there. I don't know how many more spots I have left. If you don't know what I'm going for, it'll make sense in just a second. I'm not sure if I have any spots left that I can do this. Never mind that there is a giant ladder in the way. Ha! Perfect. Look at that. That worked out perfectly. Hello, gigantic paws that I am not a big fan of. Alright, I don't even know that I have enough crossbow bolts to do this, so this might not work out very well. We're going to try it anyway, though. You just stay there, and we're going to see what happens here. I might end up killing this thing rather than actually knocking it out. So, I haven't really told you what the modification is. The modification is we're going to say, we're going back to, this was kind of suggested in the comments, actually, if I'm going to be honest here. This wasn't really my idea, I don't think. I don't know, maybe I said it at some point, I'm not sure, but pretty sure this was a suggestion in the comments that we do something along the lines of one creature from the ground, from the air, and from the water. Now, I suppose you could make ask a good question here of, what does this count as? Is this water? Is this air? Well, it's definitely not air. Is it ground? I don't really know. I would say ground. Because, you know, it doesn't have an ability to, I don't know, it doesn't have gills. How about that? We'll say it doesn't have gills. I'm going to end up killing this thing. I don't have enough to, I don't have enough to knock it out, and it's already taken way too much damage. That's a shame. I'm going to have to go spend a lot of time collecting narco berries to remake these arrows. Oh, man. Come on. Where are you, buddy? Where did you go? You didn't knock out, did you? Oh, nope. You're done. You're done raging in the corner anyway. But you didn't knock out. I didn't think so. I really need to work on a tranquilizer gun. I'm just going to give it a couple seconds here just to make sure. I don't really want to shoot you in the head, but I guess I will. I don't even know. Did that hit you in the head? I don't even think that hit you. That didn't. That hit my fabricator. That's kind of silly. Oh, perfect. Look at that. And she's out. I'll go ahead and collect all these arrows that I can. Alrighty. If I remember correctly, these things like mijo berries for one. Although I am kind of curious. Will they eat fish? I don't think they do, but seems like they should, you know. Maybe not. Maybe not. But anyway, whatever. So apparently, you know what I'm going to be doing for quite a while, because look at that. Yeah. I got a long time to spend here. But when we're all done, we're going to have ourselves a new creature to play with. So just one more time to reiterate, we're going to go ahead and change the game rules. We're going to do one ground, one air, one water creature. So we have our Argentavis up there. We might actually need to name him or her at some point. I don't know. We'll see how that goes. And we do have our Castoroides down here. And that just leaves a water creature, I guess, technically. But I'm not going to concern myself with one of those right now. The kind of sad thing is it doesn't take much to tame these guys in terms of food, but in terms of everything else, ugh, man, it takes a ton of narcotics to keep them asleep. So there we go. We didn't get the full efficiency, not even close, from this girl. I'll take that, actually. You know what? Sorry, let me grab that. I need to actually do something with that, so let me just drop that in there. So we got ourselves a Castoroides here. Pretty cool. I'm pretty excited about that. Even if I don't sound like I am, trust me, I am. These guys are a lot of fun. But we need to actually take care of things before I can get really excited here. So, nope, wrong one. We need to get ourselves a Castoroides saddle. That can be crafted at the smithy. All right, let's go do that. Smithy, smithy, smithy. All right, we're going to do saddles. Do we have what we... Crap. We need a... Of course we need a bunch of cementing paste. Why wouldn't we? Man. It makes perfect sense. I totally get it. What do we have in here? Do we have any cementing paste worth talking about in here? We do. Let's just take all of it for right now. That's fine. We'll have some leftovers. Let's go ahead and make a saddle. We're going to do a Castoroides saddle, and then I will take the remainder of that cementing paste. I'm going to put all of that back into this bad boy over here, because I think we're probably going to need out of that more than we will need it anywhere else. At least likely, I think. I need to move my bird. The last time I went out for some stuff, my bird is in the way. I can't actually climb up here. I mean, I can kind of show you. Cat, you can't be doing that. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. See, I can kind of climb up. But then my bird is in the way, so there we go. That sort of worked. Here, that'll be fine. Let's land you right there, and we will have you not follow me anymore. Yeah, that'll be fine for right now, because we need to go grab that saddle. Saddle time! We're gonna saddle up. Get on your bike and ride. Or get on your beaver and ride. Something like that. Look at that. I love it. So we got ourselves a portable smithy here. That's kind of cool. I dig that. Never mind. Pause. How they're good at storing stuff. That's pretty darn handy. All right. So, you know what? Here, we can do it this way. Let's go ahead and demolish that wall. And then theoretically, we can just ride off into the sunset here. So, doing. All right. I like that. Look at that. Ah, man. They do kind of serve two purposes. Like I said, when we were sitting down to kind of start taming. What are they? Are they underwater or are they not? Well, they can be, obviously. Oh, are you a trilobite? You look like you might be a trilobite. If you're a trilobite, I might want to kill you, actually. Let's see, is that a trilobite? I can't really see because it's so dark underwater. Yeah, it is. I can't really turn her. She doesn't turn very well, in case you didn't know. Yeah, they're not the most swift of foot on ground. Obviously, they're pretty darn awesome in the water. So, why did we get one of these girls instead of something else? Why a beaver instead of, oh, I don't know, say a T-Rex, a level 130 T-Rex, no less? That's a good question. Why would I want to do that? Oh, I don't know. It might have something to do, I can't even speak, with what these guys can gather. Now, obviously, they can gather wood like a demon. I mean, check this out. Look at that. Boom. 276 wood from one little tree. I mean, this one will be nothing right here. 240 for that little guy. And we can even go run over to this one. And look at that. That'll be 276. Thank you very much. But really, it's more about what you can get over here. Now, obviously, grabbing a bunch of berries with a beaver is not going to be terribly effective compared to, say, I don't know, using a bronto or maybe a trike, or, you know, there are a lot of things, really. I mean, many, many things you could use, really. But a beaver kind of works well because they are just so darn good at a couple different things. I mean, maybe a mammoth would be a good type of creature to get, you know, if we want to grab some wood and all that stuff, which we've been building with a lot of wood, so obviously that is a consideration. But really, the beaver here is good at getting wood. It's good at getting thatch, maybe not as much, but it's pretty darn effective at getting berries. Now, why would I want this thing to gather berries? Well, that, man, look at that food. Look how, wow, that was interesting, and then it stopped. All right, well, good. Whatever, fine. But why would I want to gather a bunch of berries? Well, that's a really fine question to ask, and I'm glad that we're having that discussion. It really comes down to, what are we going to tame after this? So if we can only have one land creature, then obviously we need one that can kind of do a variety of things. And really, that's what it comes down to. Not super fast, but fast enough. Nearby, that's definitely one of the things. Of all the nearby creatures I had as an option, this was definitely one of the better ones. But really, at the end of the day, it comes down to utility. So we have a mobile, smithy for one. We have an ability to gather a bunch of rocks and other things through me, and then store them on her to reduce the weight. Again, these things are kind of good. And of course, we can gather the berries, gather the wood, gather the fiber and thatch between the two of us. And really, we've kind of got everything figured out. Now, she's not going to be the best for gathering metal, just because we're not really going to be able to get up to the areas where there's a lot of metal to gather, but that's okay. We got the bird for that. So really, when it comes to those sorts of things, the metal, the obsidian, the crystal, we're pretty much good on that front. So why don't we go ahead and let's see if we can do a little playing while we're in here. Structures. I guess I can't in there. That's all right, though, because, you know, it's a smithy. I was thinking maybe I could just craft a bunch of stuff. I could grab a bunch of wood from her and grab a bunch, you know, make a bunch of walls and throw them back on her. But really, you know, we don't really need to do that right now. It's totally okay. We're probably good the way things are. So she can carry a good chunk of weight right now. I want to say let's go ahead and kick it up a little more. Why not? Why not? But I think we're going to go ahead and run back to our rafts, one of them at least. And then we probably need to process some stuff. I think you just dropped something I might want. Where did you leave that? You left it behind somewhere. There it is. Thank you very much. I saw that just kind of flip by me on the menu. And actually, here, while you're standing on that rock, I'm going to go ahead and beat it into the ground here and take it. Sorry, I know you like that rock. It's your friend, but I'm going to take it from you. And I don't mean to take it from you specifically. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, that's awesome. Floating beaver or something. Look at that. That's pretty cool. That is something right there. I don't know. That is bizarre. Here, can we say hi? Look at that. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Floating beaver. That is just too weird. I don't know. Whatever. Let's keep moving. Anyway, I did say we were going to go back, and we got a little more work to do, so that's okay. There's going to be a lot of that. I mean, let's just be honest. There's going to be a lot of work. That's the name of this game, really. It's called Work. Work Evolved. That's really the name of the game. All right, so we need to... Can I... From the water, I think I can, actually. There we go. Climb up. And then I don't know that I can actually... I probably can't. We're going to try this anyway, just to see what happens. I don't think it's going to work. I don't think you can carry enough. I'm going to see if I can pick you up. Yeah, okay. That worked out okay. Then I should be able to drop the beaver right there. And then we can take our bird back down and land her right about there. And just while we're talking about things, let's go ahead and give you a little more speed. Yeah, it's not a big deal with them. I mean, you know, it's not like she's getting a ton of movement speed. I totally get it, I know, but it does help out. Every little bit helps. So let's go ahead and access our Castoroides here, and thankfully you got 885 berries. I am very pleased to see that. Holy cow, I'm pleased to see that. Yes! That's actually awesome. That probably moves us a little closer to doing some other stuff. That's exciting. You should be excited about that right now. If you're not, get excited. So let's go ahead and make 97 of those bad boys. I actually need more. Do I have any spoiled meat in here? A little bit. I mean, technically, I've got a little bit of spoiled meat in there. That's four. That's something. We might need to go spoil a crap load of meat. So here, let's go ahead and craft those up. And then, how are you doing in here? Oh, look at that. We got some narco berries. You can see it's been a while. I actually emptied these out before I went to tame her. I didn't actually tell you that, but I did. And now that we have some more berries in there, man, you can kind of guess. I don't know. If you're familiar with how quickly those things kind of grow and all that sort of stuff, you could probably figure out how many days we spent just waiting to tame. Three? Four? I don't remember. It was all mostly spent at 16 times speed. I'm just going to level with you and tell you that. I mean, I do that anyway. I've told you that before. That's not really anything new. I guess I need to take this from you. I need a meat spoiling thing. I'm pretty sure there are mods for that, and I just haven't installed one. The reason I came over here is I wanted to check on these guys. So you're a middling now. You're a middling. They're kind of popping into view as I look at them. That's kind of funny. And you're a middling. So this is our citronelle. And then you are narcoberry and narcoberry. Now, something I've kind of thought about, and I don't know. I'm not sure if it would actually work out. Maybe we should look into that a little bit today. Greenhouse ceiling. That requires a stone ceiling. So if I were to do a stone ceiling, and then we could do not greenhouse, green house ceiling. There we go. What does it take to make a greenhouse ceiling? I'm going to assume a lot of crystal and probably a smithy. All right, let's go, bird. We got to go. Coming back over here. I know, we're doing a lot of bouncing around back and forth, and none of this is making any sense. It's awesome, isn't it? I enjoy it. All right, what about you? Structures, greenhouse. All right, so what do we need? We need some cementing paste, but we could actually make a couple of these guys right now. Well, cementing paste, you are over here, last I recall. We're going to grab all of you and dump you in here. I'm only going to make one, just because, wow, I got to really scroll down, don't I? Yeah, that would have been faster to do it a different way. Too late. No take backs. Let's go ahead and make a greenhouse ceiling. I'm going to grab this guy and throw you in over there. And then just to be fast, we're going to put you right on there. And then birdie, bird, bird. Birdie make bird face. Let's go ahead and hop on you. And we're going to go back to Waterworld. 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 Kind of sounds like, what's his name from Princess Bride? Marriage. There we go. So I want that one to grow faster. Theoretically, you have a greenhouse effect. Look at that. You sure do. 15%. It's not a lot. It's a little. But it'll help. So I'm going to go ahead and make a couple more of these guys. Why don't we go ahead and do that? Come on, Boyd. Let's go. We'll probably make a few of them because we actually need to plant some more things. But we'll just do two for right now. But I mean, in the future, we'll make a few more of them anyway. We don't need to concern ourselves with doing too many of them right now. And I'm going to slowly slide down the beaver there. All right, so we need two structures, greenhouse, ein, zwei, and then scroll all that down. I'll grab the handle this time. I won't mouse scroll because that was, ow, kind of painful. Speaking of painful, that would be my cat's claw on my finger. That was my fault there, not her fault. I shouldn't have tried to do that, but I did. So come on, let me up there. Oh, I hate ladders some days. All right, what about you? Are you in the way? Can I try this now? Sometimes you have to just find the right spot for the ladder. Other times, you get lucky and find it. I don't know. It's just kind of goofy. We're probably not going to be able to make any more or get a higher greenhouse effect than 15% on these guys. That's just kind of my guess. We'll see what happens over here, though, because I definitely want to put one down there. So that's going to be a 30%. How did you get 30%? How did you get 30% and that one only got 15? I guess it must be my positioning here, huh? That must not be centered enough. That'd be my guess. That's kind of a shame. Whatever. Every little bit will help, so I'm not going to argue with it. What are you going to get? Oh, don't tell me you're going to get zero. 45. Oh, yeah, look at that. Oh. Oh, I guess it just applies to everything. I get it now. That's kind of dumb. I mean, thank you. I'll take it, but that's kind of dumb. That means I could just put a bunch of these up anywhere. I guess, maybe, potentially, and they'll just apply. That's not the way I would think things work, but, again, whatever. I won't argue with it. It's cool. It's not a big deal. Come on, bird. Give me a ride. Get on your bird and ride. Because, there we go. Good stuff right there. So, theoretically, we have ourselves moving along at a pretty decent clip here. We have, crud. I wish you would spoil a little faster. That's okay, though. Theoretically, we're going to have a bunch of narcotics, and then we should probably go make some of the improved stuff. I need to go scroll all the way down to there. Yeah, more fertilizer. Gross, disgusting, fun stuff. How are you doing in here? You are actually not quite done yet. You're getting pretty darn close, though. I should probably eat a little food here just while I'm staring at it. Oh, I have one more to put in there. It's all right. We'll take care of that in just a second. Or I will. Whatever. I guess we don't have to do that together, you know. Let me grab some more gunpowder. I would like to do at least one more thing before I wrap up today. And that is kind of get us ready for a little bit more exciting stuff or sometimes the necessities, depending on how the day goes when you're doing stuff. You just never know. All right. You aren't supposed to be following me because I forgot to tell you to stop following me. So, nope. Wrong one. Wrong one. There we go. That's the right one. Added 127 spoiled meat. All right. Well, good. Then I will do that right now then since that's nice and easy to find. I'm sure this guy is long since done with all that metal. That's probably been wasting for quite a while, but that's okay. Let's add more spoiled meat. Drugs. We're only going to be able to make another 90 or so. So then I should be able to grab something along these lines. We're going to drop these guys in there. We're going to need, I think, more narco berries to do that. Is that right? Yeah, we're going to need more narco berries to make those guys. So let me grab what narco berries we have ready to go. So we're going to grab those six. And we're going to go ahead and fire out some improved narcotics because these things are awesome. The concentrated ones. Here we go. Not bad. I think we're off to a pretty decent start here. I know. We've actually been at this for quite a while. It's not really a start. But I did say I wanted to do one more thing, and that was to come in here, and I'll just queue it up with you. We don't need to hang around for all of it necessarily, but Cat, you need to get your claws out of me. I'd appreciate that. I'm going to go ahead and queue up some more bullets, because we're going to need a few of those, I think. We'll do, yeah, that sounds about right. Guess I can get rid of that down there. And then, come on. Queue up 10 of those guys. That way we have some more ammunition. We have some, we have a means of protecting ourselves. We still have all sorts of random junk in here. I kind of have stuff everywhere. Rex eggs and, do I have, I don't know, do I have any eggs stored in this guy? I feel like I do. Maybe I don't. Dilo egg, trike egg, dodo egg, titan boa eggs. And also have an IED that I don't know what to do with. But that's okay. We can worry about that another time. So we are moving forward with our plan to have one creature from each of the various areas. So one ground, one air, one water. And I think I'm going to grab those. Oh, nope. Too many. Oh, no, that's fine. I was going to say, I'm going to grab those two. That way I can make two more of these guys, and that's where we're going to leave it. So I'm not sure how many more episodes will feature our furry friend, but we'll have to figure that one out a little down the road on another day, basically. So I'll catch you on another one. Till then, thanks for watching. See you later.